Daddy's back, you bitches!
Hello, you are!
Daddy's Talk back, you me, bitches!
Follow
me! Dave, come on!
Nero! Emily!
Come on!
Nico, what are you doing?
Dave is not coming.
Ignore him! Come on, we gotta get this thing ready before we talk.
Let's go.
Here, pass me that. There she is! Liberty City!
Yeah.
You ever been?
No.
Crazy place, Nico.
What you going to do?
I might come back on board, or I might try to make a go of it. Like they say, it is the land of opportunity. I always wanted to make it big, own a nice place, get a dog, a house. Live the dream.
Like my cousin.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, he's got the love. House, women, cars, parties. He writes me in these wild emails. And after I got into trouble, I thought maybe, then I got this gig and I spend the next 7 months with you fine people and I forget. After the war finished, I couldn't get a job. Nobody could. So I did some dumb things, got involved with some idiots.
Ah, we all do dumb things. That's what makes us human.
Could be.
What?
Good to see you, man. What? You forget our language?
Capusi? Maybe a little. I've been here 10 years. You could speak English. Remember, we learned off the English girls with the big...
A little. Not so
good. You'll be fine. Better than my Serbian. Ah! So good to see you, cousin. I can't believe you made it. Shit. I have to tell you, I had quite a night last night. Two women. The land of opportunity. Ah, I've made it.
Oh.
Shit, man, I'm still a touch drunk.
A touch?
My cousin is here!
Oh,
we got to roll the
come on, relax.
Whatever, buddy. Just take over the world someplace else,
yeah,
all right?
Yeah, buddy.
You're in the goddamn
way. Screw you! Screw you all! My cousin is here! Nico Bellic! He's the fucking man, bitches!
Roman, come on, let's go. To the mansion, huh?
Yes, the mansion! Maybe you should drive.
Maybe I should.
Okay.
Okay. Hey, is this a cab? Where's the sports car?
It's in the shop. Come on!
So I could not believe it's been 10 years since GTA 4 came out. That is crazy. And this has to be possibly the most unique game in the franchise. It's the most realistic and gritty, in my opinion, and it was just mind-blowing when it first came out in 2008. I even remember the trailer coming out in 2007, and that does not feel like 11 years ago.
Terrorists! What? Terrorists! There's been a big scare, and you can't go across the bridges so good. You without the visa, I would stay in Broker. Fucking stay in Hove Beach. Everyone like us does.
And this is definitely one of Rockstar's finest moments in terms of writing. I mean, the characters and the story were amazing. So what I'm going to quickly do is trigger this first main cutscene, and then we're going to reload another one of my saves, and we're going to explore the city a bit more, and maybe do some more interesting missions.
This is the mansion?
Just a temporary place. The mansion is coming, cousin. That's the dream. Follow me. Come in, come in! Make yourself at home. What's mine is yours. Got him! Little bastard. If he paid some rent, I wouldn't care. Oh, shit. Oh, that's not nice. Oh, cousin, it's so good to see you. Oh, shit. Well, I need to change anyway. So,
you full of crap or what?
What?
Where's luxury condo? Where's sports car? Where's Barbara with big titties and Stephanie who sucks like a vacuum?
What are you talking about?
In your letters to my mother, in your letters to me, all I hear about is Mr. Big, Mr. Roman, living the American dream. Sports cars, condos, women, money, the beach, opportunity. I come here, and the only thing big about your life is the cockroaches.
That's right. I got the best cockroaches, I got the best dirt.
Screw you, you idiot!
Okay, I'm an idiot, but you must admit, I have the best line in bullshit you ever heard.
Yeah, this I know, asshole.
But here. All I needed was one good guy. One good guy I could do well. Not take over the world, but do okay. Now maybe I have this. But what about you? What about you, cousin?
What? What about me?
Why you leave home after all this time? First I hear you are running with the wrong kind. Then I hear you joined the merchant navy. Now you're here. You never tell me anything.
No.
What do you mean, no?
No, I never tell you anything. Another time.
Ooh, mystery man. Strange and exotic sailor. What happened? Did your captain make you pregnant?
Screw you! No, it's nothing like that. The ships were fine. It was before that. Two things. You remember, during the war, we did some bad things. And bad things happened to us. War is where the young and stupid are tricked by the old and bitter into killing each other. I was very young and very angry. Maybe that is no excuse. Roman? Roman! Are you sleeping, you fat fuck?
No,
come on!
What's the time? Shit. I've got to get the cab back. It's on the shift.
Stop!
Oh, Jesus! Tastes like a rat shot in it! Nico! Jeez. I've got to run. Come meet me at the cab office. It's easy. Out the door, turn left, then the first left at the diner, go down one block and turn right on Iroquois. Then walk all the way down and we're right there on the left on the corner of Cisco Street. It's really flash. We got lots of TDs and some incredible motors. Nico, give me a hug. Good to have you here, cousin. I've got something for you. Oh, damn. Damn. Yes, Vlad. Sorry. Forgive me, okay? No, please don't cut my cock off. Okay, but... Yes. Okay.
I love that cutscene. So, I mentioned that this is probably the most gritty of all the GTA games. Now, that is helped a little bit by Roman and Brucey, the actors, the two characters that sort of gave this game some comic relief. Because apart from that, it's quite a serious game, definitely. Probably the most mature of them all. Because, I mean, Vice City and San Andreas were quite comedic at times. I mean, they all had some serious moments, but this is probably the most dark of them all. Right. So let's just wander outside, and then... Oh god, the physics. Now, I do love the physics in this game. They're my favourite in the entire GTA franchise. I know a lot of people don't like the floaty cars and, you know, drifting like fuck every time you turn the corner, but I really like it. And especially the shooting as well. The shooting, you really felt the impact of all the bullets, you know, hitting your enemies. In GTA 5, it just felt a bit dumbed down. The driving and the shooting were nowhere near as satisfying. I think this perfected it. And that's my opinion. So there you go. So, I think now is probably a good time to magically fast forward to later on in the game when we've got more of the map to explore, so bear with me. Boom! Here we go. We are now in essentially the Manhattan of Liberty City with Central Park right there. I'm just going to call it the real life New York names because I remember them better than the actual game locations. Oh man, this game's classic. And I think this version of Liberty City might be, well, essentially the best version of New York City in any game I've played. I mean, Driver Parallel Lines and True Crime New York City both had impressive maps, but I think this one is definitely winning. It perfected the New York feel. And we've also got, you know, all three islands. Though actually, we've got some missions as well. Now, I can't remember what missions I've got going on. I'm really hoping this one here is A Long Way to Fall, which is one of my favourite missions. So we're going to go ahead and check out what missions we have available and have some fun. Oh, come back here. That'll do. Oh! Right, let's relive some of the awesome GTA 4 driving physics, which I honestly do love. You really feel the weight of the car. Right, what mission do we have here? I'm really hoping it's Long Way to Fall. Right, what weapons do I have anyway? Shotgun, that's good. Okay. Right, let's hope for the best. Yes, it's Long Way to Fall, get in. Let's do this one.
Oh, table for one? We got a beautiful bacala salad.
I'm here for someone. I'm here for Ray.
Oh, Ray, why did you say so? Ray's a beautiful man, you know what I mean? He's in the back.
Thanks.
Hey, Nikki! How you doing, kid?
Fine.
Hey. That Mick bastard friend of yours says you're okay.
Good.
That you're reliable.
Yep.
But can I trust you? Why go through all this? Why stick your neck out? Why do all this work?
Because I need the money. And because I can't do anything else. And because I'm good at it.
Sure.
And because I'm trying to find someone.
Okay, maybe we can help. Let's see how we do. So anyways, I got this friend. Only the friend ain't my friend no more because he ain't getting me the Vigios.
Okay.
Seems this guy does not respect the waste management business. Lives over in a project on Galveston near you. Name is Teddy Benavidez. Do what you gotta do. Somebody gets burnt, so be it.
Fine. And you'll pay.
Hey, you kidding? I'll pay double.
Good.
But you mess up, bad things are gonna happen.
I couldn't have picked a better mission to celebrate 10 years of GTA 4 with. Now, I normally go for the biker leather during this mission. I've gone for the suit for some strange reason. So let's get on with it. Now, another thing I've got to do, for old time's sake, is just run over a bunch of people. This has the best vehicular homicide physics in gaming history. I mean, GTA 5 did it pretty well, but running people over in GTA 4 was something special. They just tumbled realistically over your car. And that cop is probably blind. Oh well. Hold on, does this mission, like, make you exempt from getting a wanted level? That'd be amazing if that is the case. I think it is. Right, so we're going to run people over all the way to our mission checkpoint. Oh my god. Yes. I love that feature as well. Always wear your seatbelt. Hey. Oh no, we have one to level. Oh, okay, never mind. It was just so satisfying. I shouldn't enjoy this, but what can you do? Okay. Moving on. So let's just skip ahead to when we get to our mission location. Oh, I missed it. There we go. Right, so let's just find this guy. We know where he is already, though, so he's right in front of us.
What department Teddy Benavidez is in?
No say, I don't know no Teddies.
You sure about that? You want the last thing to come out of your mouth to be a lie?
Let's see. Shotgun. Shit, there we are.
Man. He's up on the top floor, apartment 151K. You have to walk the last few floors. Elevator don't go up there. They're fixing it up.
Cheers, mate. Oh, the shooting was perfected in this game. Right, in we go. So this mission's great for shotguns, but I haven't got that much ammo, so I'm gonna have to use machine gun. So yes, the storyline to GTA 4, definitely its selling point in my opinion, and with episodes in Liberty City being two of the best DLCs ever, it was just such a great storyline experience from start to finish. Definitely Rockstar's best in my opinion, next to Red Dead Redemption.
I think he's moving in, man. Yo, you moving in?
I'm moving in. Yeah. So I've got no armor, so I've got to be careful. What's... there we go. And the blind firing, you could just literally do the whole game with pinpoint accuracy without even leaving cover. You could aim whilst blind firing. It's great. Hold on. Come on. I think there's one more guy around the corner as well. There you are.
Your ass is mine now, son.
Hey. Oh, and the ending as well. The ending of this game is the most depressing in GTA history, but it's so good. As I said, the storyline's one of the most realistic and gritty in the entire franchise, and though there's plenty of humour in it, the story is definitely not the happiest of endings. Oh man, my health's going down big time. Tell you what.
Feels good to be fucked, doesn't it?
Oh. Right, let's actually play properly now. I haven't played this for a while, so I've forgotten how challenging it can be at times. There we are. Let's see. Sneaky. Whoa! There you are. Right, for this next bit, I want to use grenades. Have I forgotten it? Yes, I do. Right.
You fuck with me?
Get out of there.
Dead, man.
Nice. Did that work? Get in. Oh, the weapon physics were just amazing in this. I don't know why they dumbed it down for GTA 5. Right. Cutscene coming up. 3, 2, 1.
Too slow, Mama.
Right, out to the roof and straight into cover if we can find it. Yes, we can. Whee. Oh, so satisfying. Killing me will only get you killed. What's this about? Here we go. Let's wait. 3, 2, 1. Boom! Ooh! Best mission. I'm glad I got to do that one, actually. That was always one of my favourites. Just mindless fun. I've got a phone call coming shortly, I think. There we are.
Ted is dead.
What are you talking about? Ted, who's he? Sorry to hear about your loss. I'll be in touch, Nikki.
Jump out. Oh! Right, let's go shopping. I'm going to change my clothes quickly. Let's see. Now, the clothing options in this game weren't amazing, I don't think. It was very plain and bland, apart from a few nice suits, and obviously the biker leather, which I really liked. Let's see. Yeah, that'll do. Any jeans I can get? Go for the darker ones over here.
Good choice, bro. Got the same thing at home myself.
Right, we're done. Got more clothes. Now, as it's 10-year anniversary, I think we should do... Whoa! Don't know what happened. That was a nice save there. I think we can phone up... let's see. Phone book. Right, so for old time's sake, we've got to do this. Phone up Roman. And we're going to ask him to go bowling. Let's just do this, shall we? It's got to be done.
Zdravo, want to go bowling?
Cousin, I am loving the bowling. Pick me up in next hour.
Good, I will collect you, cousin.
Yeah, now let's go and get a taxi, quickly.
Where you want to go, Hefe?
How do you check? Oh, there you go. Where's Roman? There we go.
To Albany Avenue.
Nobody knows this city better than me.
Thank you very much.
Hey, Roman.
NP, my cousin. Why don't we find a car so we can go?
There's one right here. Right, so what's the closest, let's see. That one there, or that one there.
This country, it's fucking amazing!
I want some of what you're on. It must be pretty strong because I can't see what you're so happy about. Life is shit.
I'm high on life, man. American life. It's the fast food, the cheap gas, the fake titties. This is a shortcut for everything here. You just need to know where it is.
Yeah, but most people don't know where it is, so they stay at the bottom of the food chain. They stay there until they're burnt out or dead.
That's because most people are too foolish to look for the shortcuts. They stay on the highway like every other chump. I'm an innovator, Nico. I drive off the highway. Off-road, baby! Every move I make is a gamble. I'm going to get knocked back a few times, sure. But one day, I'll find that shortcut to the top. If you're lucky, I might take you there with me.
Tell me, Roman, why weren't you such an optimist back home?
In the old country, the only thing you could count on was a bomb landing on your bedroom roof in the night. Here, anything is possible. It's the land of opportunity. They must put something into the water, man, because all I'm feeling is pure optimism.
I'm going to start drinking from the tap, then.
And here we are. Roman's favorite pastime. Let's go. Still a half game. We haven't got all day. Right now, I forgot how to play this. get into position. Okay. Oh, nice. Oh, that's annoying. Dead. Now, I'm actually hoping that I've got another mission that I want to do called Final Interview, which is another one of my favourite missions, and we might have that available right now. If we do, we'll do it after this bowling. Go on, Roman, you can do it. Yeah, move over, let me own you. I won't show you this whole match. It's obviously quite boring. I'm just doing it for old time's sake because of the meme about Roman and the bowling obsession. Oh.
Okay, not bad.
All right, let's try. Come on. Yes. Right, last go. Let's see if I can get a strike. Come on, come on, come on. Damn it! Well, I won just by 3 points. That was a close game.
Tika, good game. You're good at bowling, and I'm good with the ladies. We both have skills. Take me home, Nico.
Oh bloody hell! It's Kate.
Nico, hi. It's Katie, Patrick's sister.
Hey, what's up?
I was wondering if you wanted to do something sometime. I don't normally like the hood to hang out with my brothers, but you seem different.
Maybe I am different.
Come pick me up. I'm free now.
Yes, no, what do we do? Screw it, let's do it.
Sure, I'll be there in the next hour. I'll see you then, Kate.
See you, Nico.
Now, I'm not the biggest fan of Kate. I find her quite annoying. Ending, I always choose to save Roman. Because, one, he's family, and two, he's a better character than Kate. Bollocks. I forgot to slow down for the toll booth. Whoa. Okay, can I fit in? No, I can't. Normally I fit in the side bit there and drive off, and it helps you get away from the cops easier. So we're going to go, pick up Kate, but if she insults me just once, we're gonna end the date and go crazy. So I've noticed doing her. Oh god! Dude! Oh no, we've missed our date. You got run over. I wonder if it's still available. Oh no. Oh dear. You know what? I don't actually care. I'm kind of glad that happened. Oh, God. Right, here we go. So we're going to do this mission, and then we're going to end with a shootout in the hospital, of all places. Because that's something I missed from GTA 5. The hospital was such a great place to go and cause havoc. As morally wrong as it is, but this is GTA, for God's sake. So yeah, let's go and complete this admittedly easy but fun mission. Okay, we're at the internet cafe, and shit! Right. So we're gonna send the email, then I'll get my suit on, we'll do this mission, and then we'll end on a crazy shootout in the hospital.
Can I get you a smoke a lot of latte?
Nah, I'm good, mate. Okay, let's see. Now, I've forgotten what I've got to do to actually send the... Careers... Submit resume. Nice one. Okay, we're done. I think. Right, so we'll fast forward to when we finally get the interview.
There's a tip jar, jackass.
Mr. Bellick, this is Karen from Goldberg, Lincoln, and Schreister. We'd like to arrange an interview for you at the earliest at noon tomorrow. Is that all right?
I can free that period up in my schedule.
Super. Your interview will be with Mr. Goldberg. Press the buzzer and we'll let you in. Have a nice day.
Hell yeah, we're set.
Let's get going.
So I'm just gonna go and change my suit.
I have an interview with Goldberg tomorrow.
Perfect. The smug bastard ain't gonna know what's coming at him. Teach him for sticking his nose in other people's business and get the files.
Okay. No, wrong way. I'll go for the suit I was wearing before with the pink tie. Normally the one I use for this mission. There we are. Perfect. So, we're going to go to sleep in our suit and then wake up tomorrow for the interview. There we go.
Later.
Right, finally. Got the interview, finally ready to go. So, we're going to go for the stealth approach this time because it's just a bit more... I don't know. In a way, it's funner. We're going to be jumping out of the window up there with hopefully no one shooting at us. That's the plan anyway. Could go horribly wrong, but we'll find out. Here we go.
It's Nico Bellic. I'm here for an interview.
Come in, I'll buzz you through.
Right, nice and subtle-like.
Welcome to Goldberg, Ligner, and Scheister, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Bellic, welcome. I'll just see if Mr. Goldberg is available. Mr. Goldberg, Mr. Bellic has arrived for his interview.
Okay, great. Tell him to come through to my office.
Would you please follow me, Mr. Bellic?
Sure.
Mr. Goldberg is such a saint. He teaches kids to swim, you know. He's just so warm and giving. All he cares about is making the world a better place. And boy, are you in trouble if you get in his way.
Do you think he'll like me?
Do you think he'll like me?
He's just in here. Don't be nervous. He doesn't bite.
Okay, here we go. Moment of truth.
Hello, Nico. What's that short for, Nikolai? I'm looking for a man who can get jobs done right. Nikolai, I like your resume. You seem to be the sort of man who would go the extra distance. I just need to take another look. Get myself reacquainted with your experience.
Was I here for a little bit and listen to what he's got to say?
So, you're the sort of man who doesn't wait to get told what to do. A guy who looks at the world, sees problems, and tries to fix them?
Sure.
My problem is that people don't notice the decay in society. They leave the decay alone, and soon it's too late, so you have to pull the whole tooth.
Yeah?
I'm the guy who goes around shaking people. For people, read society, read City Hall. I shake them, and I say floss. Get rid of the rock.
Sure, stand up now.
Stand up if you want to. Whatever makes you comfortable. There's this cop. Good cop, but he thinks he's above the law. He's not. You wanna know why? Because the law is clear. I'm gonna crush him.
Yeah. There we go. Right. Out the window or... Yeah. Oh no. No, it didn't work. Oh well. What I should have done is walked out the bloody door. Well, we did it anyway. That's the best we're gonna get.
What the hell are you doing? Asshole.
Get out of the vehicle.
Go away. Right. Ramp it. Damn it. Hey. So, that didn't go as planned. I completely forgot that. Sometimes, if you go out the window, you get a wanted level. We should have walked out the front door, like, just casual, like, oh well. Bloody hell, that was a really long cop chase. I finally lost them on the other island. I managed to drive back and finally give the files to Francis. And we could end the mission. That didn't go as smoothly as planned, unfortunately.
Here are the files. Great. Peace at last. I feel cleansed. You silenced Goldberg too, right? I don't need to worry about him? He's done. Whoa, music to my ears. A weight has been lifted. Here's your payment.
All that for $1,000. Jesus. I feel used. Right, so. Time for the shootout. Right, here we go. So we're somewhere near the hospital. I'm going to just jump out of the helicopter and hopefully land in the water so I don't die. 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, that's close. That is so close. If I land on the boat, that'd be great. Hey! And the water looks beautiful in this game. The way it glistens. Right, okay, so... we're not too far away from hospital, so we should be able to... don't run me over! That's close. Should be able to run there pretty quickly. Right, we're there. West Dyke Memorial Hospital. Let's do this. A feature that is unique to GTA 4 is the ability to go inside hospitals and literally kill everyone. So, just going to casually walk in and throw a grenade. Go, go, go!
Look out.
Okay, what? That should have killed someone. Oh, nice. Okay. It's gonna get brutal.
Get down. He's got a gun.
You want to be messy?
Help me, please.
So I've got health there. Let's see. Ooh. There's cops. Where are the cops? Oh, they're outside. I won't kill these guys. That feels wrong. Okay. This video is going to get demonetized. I can just see it happening. Oh well. What the hell does that say? He said doing it standing up wouldn't get me knocked up. He lied. Ha! I never noticed that before. That's great. Oh, 3 headshots. Beautiful. This is too easy, guys. Come on. Oh, can't shoot through the glass.
Don't make me kill you.
Right, so we got 5 stars now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to hide down the back of this corridor here, which is what I normally do. And they'll all come running down in a straight line. And this is where we kill the guy in the mission flatline.
Dispatch new
came from left wood.
Oh god, that was quick. Oh.
Anymore?
Also, this is what really impresses me a lot with this game. You can, hold on a minute. You can actually shoot weapons and they move along the floor. That is amazing. The guns actually have textures. That really impressed me. Oh, the SWAT team are here. I mean, look at this. They actually move. That's great.
I need immediate assistance. Place to
go. Ambulance for a three alarm fire.
Walking out in the open like a twat. Okay, well, that was a pretty decent shootout right there. And just to show off some of the amazing shooting mechanics of this game, which I really like. And there we have it, guys. The masterpiece that is GTA 4, which is 10 years old, which is unbelievable. It feels like 5 years, not 10. But yeah, this one of the best storylines in the franchise, without a doubt. And yeah, combine this with The Ballad of Gay Tony and Lost and Damned, and it was just incredible. So, there we have it, guys. 10 years of GTA 4, and here's to another 10 years. And hopefully we'll get a remaster one day. So until next time, I'll see you guys on the next nostalgia trip. Take care, guys.